you're going to be quiet and come with me right now, because I'm going to show you the seven wonders of the modern smart home. If you haven't noticed, creating the ultimate smart home has nothing to do with Google or Apple or Amazon anymore. It's all to do with free open source solutions that you can't live without. This video could save you thousands. These are absolutely amazing wonders that interconnect together and allow you to achieve pretty much anything. From photo frames that act as calendars when you need them, to smart ornaments that tell you how your solar system is doing, to interactive lighting controls, to smart paintings that set the scene for the room. Adding them to your toolkit will let you unlock pretty much everything in your house, and most importantly, get rid of those stupid manufacturer apps. And they're all free, with one exception, which I will argue is even better than free. But wait and see if I can convince you. So, without further ado, let's begin. The first wonder is Home Assistant. This helps you control all of the smart gadgets in your home from one place. Home Assistant is an extraordinary piece of software. It's free, it's powerful, and open source. It's a home automation platform that puts local control and privacy first, supporting basically every device that you can think of across any brand without the need for cloud dependency. In the same way everyone now Googles for a real search result by adding Reddit at the end of their search, I now buy items for the home with Home Assistant at the end. If it hasn't been integrated, which is rare, then it's a no-no. You can install Home Assistant on pretty much any device, from a Raspberry Pi to a PC, or you can just buy a pre-built device that does it all for you. Either way, it's cheap, totally customizable, and open source. You name it, it's got it. Voice control, smart web interface, app control, and thousands of integrations for everything you can think of. These guys deserve a Nobel Prize for the work they've done for humanity, and it's constantly improving too. I have a little moment every time they release a new version. So, we've got a brain, but we need sensors to trigger events in our smart home. That's where we come to the second wonder, a true jewel of the maker world, the ESP32 microcontroller. The ESP32 is like a tiny brain that you can connect all your sensors to for all of your DIY smart projects. This dinky powerhouse makes it super easy to build your own little devices to sensor, monitor, and control devices all around the home. I love them so much, so cute. There are millions of great videos out there with people demonstrating their innovations using these. People use them to control just about everything. They can also be used to turn non-smart devices smart. These chips are super cheap and will cost just a few pounds or dollars each and have low power usage. This suddenly unlocks your ability to fill your house with smart devices. The ecosystem around this is developing every day. There are some smart all-in-one sensors starting to pop up that will push things even further as well. Imagine having a device in a room that can monitor temperature, noise levels, air quality, movement, light levels, humidity, and more. The mind boggles with the cool stuff that you could achieve. So you've got Home Assistant as your brain and ESP32 chips ready to sense, but you're not much of an electronics engineer. Well, fear not. This is where the third wonder comes in, ESP Home. ESP Home makes it easy to tell those tiny ESP32 brains what to do
without you having to be a programmer.
It acts as a simple intermediary between Home Assistant and every one of your ESP devices. It handles everything. You can find hundreds of guides on their site that cover how to wire up basically any component, and you can just plug in wires and you're away. It has super simple code that you can copy, paste, and tweak to suit your use case, and it sorts out all the wireless connectivity, over-the-air firmware upgrades, and everything that you could think of. It's completely free, with an awesome community all working to make the smart world a cooler. It seamlessly integrates into Home Assistant also, so suddenly your brain is picking up the nervous system of your house. Now, whilst everything can connect by Wi-Fi that I've covered, I now should introduce the fourth wonder, Zigbee 2 MQTT.
Zigbee 2 MQTT lets different smart devices talk to each other.
Very quickly, Zigbee is a popular wireless communication standard used in many smart home devices, primarily driven by its low power consumption and mesh networking capabilities. So it can communicate by bouncing from one device to the next. MQTT is a classic nerd name, message, queuing, telemetry, transport. But in essence, it's a lightweight messaging protocol. You almost certainly have Zigbee devices in your house. Your smart bulbs, smart plugs, door window sensors and motion sensors, temperature and humidity sensors, smart thermostats, smoke and carbon monoxide detectors, and loads more. This provides super fast responsive triggering of all these devices. In fact, I actually find that lights switch on much faster using this than the native apps, which are usually bouncing off some cloud, some server somewhere. And yes, it integrates wonderfully with Home Assistant. Okay, so we have all our devices either integrated directly into Home Assistant or using Z2M to connect. We have lots of custom sensors appearing using ESP32s and ESP Home. We now need to free ourselves from opening our phones, unlocking, loading apps. You can use this Home Assistant app, which is great as you can put everything in one place and design it to perfectly suit your use case. However, sometimes you don't want to even have to do that. There is a broad ecosystem of smart buttons you can buy. IKEA trad-free ones that I use, which are pretty cheap. However, there is a cost limit and a visual limit to how many buttons you want to litter about your house. This is where a super cheap and invisible solution comes in. So the fifth wonder costs literally pennies, usually around just 5p or a few cents per tag. I'm talking about the RFID tag. Just look at this thing. It is an amazing tool to have.
RFID tags contain a tiny radio frequency transponder, radio receiver, and transmitter that can be embedded in something like a simple sticker. When you hold a reader near them, such as your phone, they can trigger actions like turning on lights or unlocking doors.
You can buy them as sticky labels like this one, or printable credit card style plastic, key tags, or anything that you can imagine. They require no batteries, of course, and they last forever. They really are a brilliant invention that I'll need to do a whole video on one day. They most famously were used by the Soviets to spy on the Americans, but these days they're ubiquitous in asset tracking, payment systems, secure entry, LIBI tracking, airport baggage handling, and loads more. You can control them using a dedicated reader or just use your phone or any smart device. Think about this. There are loads of things that we do if we could just be bothered. For example, wouldn't it be nice whenever you got home you could just set the lights to evening mode and turn on some relaxing music? But you don't, do you? Because let's go through the steps. Open your phone, open the Hue app, set the lighting level, close the app, open the Sonos app, choose the speaker sets, select the playlist, hit play, adjust the volume level. Oh, it's just not going to happen, is it? You just want to drop your phone down and relax. But that is exactly what you can do for 5p. They add a wonderful sense of intrigue by their hidden nature. They're just so easy to add to anything. They're just so thin. I can literally just stick this under the table and I now have a smart table that I can just tap with my phone to do something. I can stick it on me. And when you tap your phone on me, I can become smart. Or just maybe play some music. My dining room has a whole series of paintings with RFID tags behind them that trigger individual themes of music. British, American, Italian, whatever I want to match the kind of food that we're eating. And then from top to bottom, we have three levels of beat. Top being upbeat, middle being normal, and bottom being chilled. So I can just tap my phone and the music magically starts playing whatever playlist I want. So now you can cover your house with sensors and triggers. However, sometimes you need the devices to communicate to you. And the fastest method known to man is the speed of light. This is where the sixth wonder comes in. WLED.
WLED lets you change the colours and patterns of your lights really easily. So you can then use this to get your devices to talk to you using light signals.
It is a lovely bit of software that lets you turn basic LED strips into smart controllable effects powerhouses. Guess what? It uses ESP32s, it works brilliantly with Home Assistant, but it's just an amazing controller that connects seamlessly to Home Assistant and lets you program literally thousands of bespoke lighting effects. It can use flames to show you one thing and gradients to show you another. Okay, we come to the final wonder. And this is where it gets a bit controversial. But hear me out. I've just saved you thousands and thousands of pounds. I've made your life so much better and freed you from the grip of dozens of cynical corporate entities. So basically, you owe me. So keep all those thousands for yourself. But I want you to go and buy yourself a gift. And that gift is a 3D printer.
A 3D printer is a device that can create physical objects from digital designs that you can create yourself or download. This will let you create custom parts, containers, or decorations for your home gadgets.
Now, 3D printers have amazing slicers that are completely free. And my shout would be the brilliant Orca slicer that is fighting the increasing closed box mentality of the printer makers. But you will need to buy a printer to use them. I would be astonished if the actual cost of your 3D printer wasn't essentially free within 6 months. They pay for themselves so quickly. For me, it was all those shelf brackets that I would have paid for my Sonos speakers, the tool holders, the wall hooks. It took a month before I was at the point that I'd saved more than the purchase price. And since then, it's been unbelievable savings. The reason I've included this is an essential final part of creating your smart home. It allows you to create all the custom boxes for your ESP chips, covers for your smart LEDs, bespoke solutions for your wall mounts. It is the final tool in your arsenal that you need to toss away all the high cost, low feature solutions from tech giants. So I hope you enjoyed that quick trot through some of my favorite solutions. There are, of course, hundreds of other platforms and ecosystems. But my goal with this was to share my view of the tools that I use to make a smart home and give you a simple list rather than a dizzying array of options. With these 7 solutions, you hopefully can see just how much you can automate across your house with relative ease. Now, please do let me know if there's something missing or worthy of adding. There are a few things that get me as excited as discovering a new open source ecosystem. So please do suggest in the comments. Oh, And please, please, please let me know any cool ideas that you've got that could be built. It's so exciting to see them, and it gives me new ideas of crazy projects that I could build. I've already covered a lot of examples of how I'm using these tools in my house, but I've got even more coming up. So keep watching to see how they all come together.